So it turns out if we want to understand TD lambda, a really useful way of studying it is by studying not TD lambda. So in particular, we're going to look at k-step estimators for a moment, and then we're going to relate that back to TD lambda. So here's what a k-step estimator is. So let's say we're trying to estimate the value of a state, st, so it's a state that we just are leaving, as a function of what happens next. So let's look at this first estimator here. It says that we're going to estimate the value of a state that we're leaving by moving it a little bit in the direction of the immediate reward plus the discounted estimated value of the state that we landed in. And we're going to just move a little bit in that direction. So do you recognize this? Have you seen this before?
I believe I have seen this before.
What do we call it?
I don't remember anymore.
Oh, well, that's unfortunate. So,
but I've seen it before. It's just like a one-step look-ahead sort of thing.
Yeah, exactly, which is what we were calling TD0.
Oh, right. Yes. Yes, that makes sense.
And in fact, you're exactly right that the way to think about that is a one-step estimator, right? So it's a one-step estimator in that we use the immediate reward that we got plus the value of the state that we land in. But let's contrast that with a two-step estimator. We'll call it E2, estimator 2, where what we do is to estimate the value of a state that we're leaving. We're going to move a little bit in the direction of the immediate reward that we received plus the discounted reward that we received next plus the double discounted value of the state that we landed in two steps from now. So now instead of where we were before, we did an estimate by taking one reward and we estimate the rest of the sequence using our current estimates. Here we're taking two rewards and using that as our immediate estimate plus our estimate of the future taken as the state that we reach two steps from now. So does that make sense kind of as an extension of that idea?
No, that makes sense. So if E1 is a one-step look ahead, then E2 is a two-step look ahead.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So we use two steps, two real steps, followed by this kind of look-ahead thing. And we could do that for 3, right here. And we could do that for K, where we're estimating the value of a state by K rewards, summed up here, plus, and then we estimate the value of the future by looking at the state we end up in K steps from now and discounting that by K steps. And in fact, if we continue doing this arbitrarily, we eventually get to E infinity, where let's see what would happen in that case. So we get the sum of rewards, and it keeps going, and it keeps going. And eventually, at infinity, we look at the state that we end up at infinity, which of course isn't a real thing. But then it's okay, because we discount it by gamma to the infinity, which is 0. So this piece of the term actually drops out, and we just end up with this infinite sum of rewards. Now, this last estimator should look familiar to you too, Charles.
Yeah, that looks like TD1.
Good. So now we've got TD0 on the one side as a one-step estimator and TD1 on the other side as an infinity-step estimator. And we've got these other things in between that we don't really have or possibly even need a name for.
Well, that makes a lot more sense with the title K-step estimator. So I was worried this was going to turn into some kind of commentary about dubstep.
Oh, yes. Break it down. So that's not going to happen in this case.
That's probably for the best.
So what I need to do next is actually relate these quantities to TD lambda, which we're going to show is a weighted combination of all these estimators.
All infinity of them?
All infinity of them.
Oh, that's pretty impressive.